People in Japan have eaten eel for thousands of years. Unagi, or freshwater Japanese eel, can cost more than bluefin tuna. A kilogram of these baby eels cost around $35,000. Watch till the end, click subscribe and the bell button on our channel to see more about how Japanese farming, harvesting, and processing millions of these most expensive eels meet in the world. Enjoy! And unlike other types of fishing, the majority of eels are raised, not caught as adults. Instead, young eels are raised on farms. It can take 6 to 12 months of work before eels are big enough to be sold. Young eels, called glass eels, are 100% caught in the wild and raised on a farm like this. No farm in Japan has been able to efficiently breed the eels in captivity, so farmers depend on the catch of young eels to make profit. And this is how millions of glass eels are caught. Nobody knows how they breed, but ocean currents bring them. Their price is extremely expensive, about $1.5 for a 0.2 gram eel. And raising this many eels requires consistent attention. Here they are raised in stages, based on size. From glass eels, they change to elver or yellow eels. Then they will be moved to the farming pond. They are not easy fish to grow. If one disease spreads or one accident happens, then everything in the pond is gone. You can never make a profit. So you can see here how Japanese are farming them. Pond environment, clothes, adequate oxygen, and shape. The iron frame is where the eels come in to eat. After the cost of the eels themselves, feeding them is the most expensive part. Eels often forage at night. They are more active in the dark. It's time to eat, and these workers need to prepare food. Adult eels usually eat 3 meals a day. The special type of food is a mixture of fish meal, wheat, soybean meal, and fish oil. They are well mixed and form a thick paste. Eels like it. And now they're trying to feed them in a way that food gets around to all 150,000 eels. That is a difficult task. In a year, the farm raises about 4.5 million adult eels. After 6 to 12 months of work, eels are big enough to be sold. And this is how they harvest eels, dredge the bottom net, or use a pump. Normally, each eel weighs about 200 grams. People use ice to reduce the activity of eels. Workers unload the eels and sort them by size to determine where they'll be sold. Experienced workers can quickly tell the difference just by feel. These crates are added with cold water for shipping. Some of these eels will end up at restaurants, or they can be brought to the market and grilled eels factory. And last but not least, the eel processing plant. To keep eel fresh, the workers make the eel in a dormant state at the shortest time. And these professional technicians strictly remove the eel's bones, head, and guts. The skilled workers will remove the eel's dorsal fins and make them trimmed. This is an automatic eel grill machine only available in Japan, and workers need to arrange the eel on the roasting line first. Whole roasting the skin and the flesh. Grill 24 carbon fire grooves to roast the eel with carbon fire to make them more delicious. Then they put these eels for roasting first to remove unnecessary fat, and roasting the meat to make the eel cook through. Steam cooking. Each boneless eel is steam cooked to make the meat softer and more delicious and sterilized. Roasted eels without sauce first, and to employ traditional workmanship by using high quality and special sauce. with 4 courses of seasoning processes to make eel more flavorful. IQF for the purpose of keeping the unique flavor of eels, finished products are immediately sent to be frozen under minus 33 degrees Celsius for an hour so that the central temperature of the products can drop to under minus 18 degrees Celsius with metal. Inspectors to inspect eels one by one for the ensuring that no metal fragment remained in each product. With the computer-controlled automatic weight checker, we check the weight size, shapes, and specifications. And we go to the packing part. These workers put each cooked eel in individual packaging based on different grades. The name of the quality inspector, expiration date, allergen label, production batch number, product designation, and specification are marked on the paper carton. Each box of products is checked with the metal inspector for ensuring that no metal fragment is contained within it. CIQ performs inspections on the products apart from self-checking to guarantee the only qualified products can go to shipment. That's the end for today. Thank you for watching the video. Any other agriculture technology that you want us to have included? Let us know in the comment section. See you in the next video.
This video has brought you useful information and helped you answer your questions. If you have any questions or comments, leave a comment below. And don't forget to support us by liking and subscribing to our channel so you don't miss the latest videos.